Triathlon training while traveling, day 9. And surprise, surprise, day 9 was yet another travel day. But before we did any traveling, we needed to get our fitness in. Now, if you watched day 8, then you would know that I had some unfinished business with a run workout. And so I was out to go finally complete that fartlek workout. And so to the coffee machine we went. And once again, boy, was I impressed with this hotel's coffee maker. A very simple, easy to use user interface that even came with pictures so you knew exactly what you were going to get. Look, all you had to do was hit the little button or press the little screen, whatever you want to say, and then within a few seconds, you had the true nectar from the gods pouring into your cup. After we got our coffee in us, here is a little screen recording of me making this fartlek workout. It was a pretty simple one, just 3 minutes, 2 minutes, 1 minute, getting a little faster as the interval shortens. After I made that run workout on the Garmin, I sent it over to my watch. Here's a little video of me showing everyone how I'm ready to go. It was a little cooler today, so I decided to put it on the tank top. Now, I didn't want to take my phone with me because I wanted to be in the zone. So here's a little screenshot of the run, a little screen recording of the intervals. I only did it 3 rounds, not the full 5 rounds, because I felt good after 3 and I didn't want to push it. Now, since during the run, we were hitting some pretty fast paces, at least for myself, I was feeling a little bit tight. My IT band was definitely not the happiest it's ever been. So I got out the little, I don't even know what to call this, little rumble ball, I guess you could say, and I did some much needed rolling and stretching and all of the above on that IT band and that glute. Now, after we got all loosened up, we went back to the breakfast area because I needed some protein in me to help rebuild all those muscles that I used during that run workout. And because we were in a rush, I had to take this breakfast to go. So here's me putting all the protein into a cup. It's like a DIY protein shake with actual meat. And here's a little video of the drive. It was absolutely gorgeous. We were headed off to a little lake in Italy. Here's a little video of what our hotel looks like. It was actually on the lake. You can see for yourself. It's called Lake Lugano. Here's what my room looked like when I checked in. Had a gorgeous view. Boy, am I going to be enjoying my work while I'm staying here. Now, after we got all checked in, we went to a local bike shop to see if I could rent a bike for a few days, but they were sadly closed. However, I did get a hold of the owner through WhatsApp, and he said he will be there on Monday. They're actually out racing in Italy today, so that's why they weren't there. But once we got back to the hotel, it was time to go swimming. I made sure to bring my orange floating buoy and my bright orange cap so my mom could see me and so she wouldn't have to call the Italian police on me as well. And here's a little video she took. As you can see, it was pretty choppy out there. Hopefully it's not this choppy the entire time I'm here, because I did not swim very far, I tell you that much. I think I actually floated more than I swam, that's for sure. But after that, I was pretty exhausted, so that's all the training I did for the day. We went out for a short dinner and off to bed. Hope you guys all enjoyed day 9 of triathlon training while traveling. And we'll see you tomorrow for day 10. Double digits, would you look at that.